here, which is the feet are constructed in the most simple form.
Well, I'm going to, before we move on, can I put this drawer out just to make this comparison?
He's bigger than I am.
This is going to be real short. I'll pass this around. When you look at that Weathersfield fan, it's very well executed, but kind of reserved and conservative. When you look at this drawer, which came out of a desk over here that has design and construction associated with New London County, in New London County, they like to kind of spice that fan up a little bit, and they use some punch work and carving outside the fan and scribe line carving to the rays. So this is essentially the same fan as the one on the high boy, but you're not going to confuse the two. This one has all these different elements and all these additional designs that are put together with it. And that's one of the ways you can tell Weatherfield Furniture and New London County Furniture, how they're different from each other, is how they treat the shell design. Who did we say we thought maybe we don't know? Well, William Manley was one of the early, he's credited with bringing Queen Anne style from coastal Massachusetts to Connecticut around 1730. This is a little bit later, this is 1765 to 1775, so it's a second generation of someone after William Manley, but he's a really important character.
What we're going to do, just so everybody can at least see the way the feet are, we're going to actually put this chest up on this one. And this shows you what the feet looks like and proves that you can actually use these, because we're going to put a whole chest of drawers right on the top of this. And we're not afraid to do it either.
And before, as we tilt this up too, what you want to look at is the shape of the top. This is a straight front case, but has a serpentine shaped top, which is very particular to Windsor.
Stain into it, the scratch test doesn't work. because the stain goes into the wood. And so that is very important. That's one of the first things we all learn, collectors, dealers, museum people, anybody who's interested, you've got to know the scratch test. And after a while, we know what an aged board is supposed to look like. That's what it's supposed to look like. That, this is textbook. This is like perfect examination of what the bottom of the chest should look like. But the simplicity of this one is really quite amazing. This was made somewhere, we think, between the Suffield and perhaps Deerfield area along the Connecticut River. We've included it in our talk because it could very well be around Suffield area. The scallop top is very indicative of anywhere from East Hartford, Hartford up to Suffield, up into Deerfield. And it's pretty much the only place it did it. However, Kevin has another theory, which we will get to shortly. And so I actually agree with his theory. So anyway, you want to add anything to it?
No, before we get into theories, this is all Eastern white pine. This is a single board of white pine for the bottom. And then, so something to notice about this for regional characteristics of that upper Connecticut Valley is this very simple pointed return on the feet. Kind of hard to see the way it's laying right now, but when you get a chance, look at it. And it's very Massachusetts influenced. So this is a very similar design to the foot that you would see in Massachusetts, and it's kind of middle of the road, conventional OG foot with a little spur return. The way the base molding is made, it's just a thin piece of molding that's applied to the case that allows it to, you know, to give that decorative transition from the case to the feet. The theory starts when you start to look at the shape of this top. And the shape of this top and the beveled edge is closely related to a tilt top tea table known as the Anna Barnard table. Her wedding furniture was made by Eliphalet Chapin of Windsor. And so this piece has a couple elements that are related to Eliphalet Chapin's workshop in design and construction. But the shape of this top and this very kind of subtle rounded beveled edge is right from Chapin's design book. As a matter of fact, Arthur just brought over this tilt top tea table that has a round top. So if you imagine this table with a top shaped like this, with four rounded corners and serpentine sides going all the way around, that's what the Anna Barnard tea table looks like.
One of the things I've always thought is antique furniture is very tactile. You just want to touch it. So later on, after we're done, just come over and feel the edge. Just feel the angle of the edge, and then feel the angle of the edge on that chest. It is remarkably the same. So it is very possible. We know this table was made by Eliphalet Chapin or his shop. And we know that the Barnard table is made by the Chapin shop. So Kevin's theory is that it is not far out of the realm of possibility that this chest could be a very early example of a level of shape because the edge is so, so similar. And so we just happened to have this shape table right standing right there. That's why I thought I'd bring it over here. I mean, really, we are spontaneous. This was not planned at all.
And this is a really subtle but kind of important element. And kind of like the shape of the edge of the top. One of those things that a cabin maker would do because that was his training or something he thought was important, but it's not necessarily something that's going to be copied by a competitor because it's kind of, they would do their own element as far as construction goes. But another important element in the world of Eliphalet Chapin and his furniture is the way he would shape the top of the side of the drawers. And there's a little tiny single bead on the outside edge of the drawer side. And that is right out of Chapin's workshop. And it wasn't used by very many other people in the area. Again, it was something that was particular to his workshop. So when you get a chance to look at this chest up close, or you're looking at another piece that you want to figure out, is it made in Windsor, is it associated with Eliphalet Chapin, look for that little bead on the outside edge of the drawer signs. But a good question.
One for the drawer, I'll explain.
So, wood against wood. You don't want the drawers combined. One of the things that we always do is we will never sell a piece of furniture with a drawer that does not move smoothly. First of all, it puts wear and tear on the piece of furniture, and it's not good, and we don't want people bitching us out because the drawers don't work. So we make sure that those drawers work really well. Well, that top edge with a little molding makes it so that's the only part that touches the drawer blade above it. So absolutely, less friction, less possible wear and tear on the chest, and Mrs. Jones is happy. Now it just makes life a whole lot easier, and you don't have to kick the drawer in, breaking the backboard.